You're welcome to Open Heaven's Devotional Commentary, a guide to a close fellowship with God. I'm Salam Manager Haruna, your host. We are glad to have you.
Hello, good morning. Thank you for joining us today again. Open Heaven is written by our Father in the Lord, Pastor E.A. Adeboye, General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And this commentary is intended to bring insight to God's Word by the help of the Holy Spirit. Today's date is Wednesday, the first day of September 2021. Congratulations and welcome to a brand new month. In this new month, we receive divine wisdom and leading by the Spirit of God in Jesus' name. Our topic for today is the call to salvation. Let us pray. Eternal Father, we thank you for your love over us. Thank you for the brand new month that you've let us see. We thank you for the gift of your word also that we have before us today. Unless you speak to us, there can be no understanding. We ask that you would open the eyes of our understanding to the truths of your word in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. You're welcome back. Our memory verse for today is from the book of Matthew chapter 11 verse 29. Matthew 11 29 reads, "Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls." Matthew 11 verse 29. And our scripture reading for today is from the same book of Matthew chapter 11. We'll be reading from verse 28 to 29 now. Matthew 11 verse 28 to 29 reads, "Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls." God bless his word in Jesus' name. Amen. In this new month, our Father in the Lord tells us today that there are basically two people involved in a call: the caller and the called. The basic divine call is what we find in Matthew 11 verse 28 to 29. Here, God is the caller and the called are all men. It is a call unto salvation, which is universal. It hinges on John chapter 3 verse 16, a call from the heart of God. Hebrews 9 verse 27 says, "And it is appointed unto men once to die, but after this, the judgment. To be forewarned is to be forearmed." It is, however, amazing that some people who are considered wise because of their educational attainments prove to be the least wise when it comes to matters relating to God. Romans 1 verse 28 says, "And even as they did not like to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not convenient." A call once went out to the first man, Adam, in Genesis 3 verse 9. This was after his fall to sin. Unfortunately, man mismanaged this opportunity by not accepting responsibility for his sin, but rather decided to blame his wife, Genesis 3 verse 12. Another opportunity came through Jesus Christ, the second Adam and our Redeemer. Congratulations to you if you have responded to this call that came through Jesus Christ according to our Bible reading of today. Having received this call, we are now children of the Most High God. We are now heirs of God and joint heirs with the Lord Jesus Christ. Romans 8 verse 17, 1 John 3 verse 1. Beloved, having answered the call to salvation, we have some obligations to fulfill. We cannot love the world and God at the same time. 1 John 2 verse 15 to 17. We must deliberately separate ourselves from the darkness of the world so that the Almighty God who made the call can receive us. 2 Corinthians 6 verse 14 to 18. If, however, you haven't heeded God's call for salvation, I enjoin you to do so right away, as tomorrow may be too late. Seek the Lord when he can be found, Isaiah chapter 55 verse 6, and surrender your life to Jesus Christ today. I pray that God will keep us all true to our ultimate salvation in the kingdom of heaven, in the mighty name of Jesus. God bless his word to us today in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Our topic for yesterday was "The Countdown Has Begun." And in our devotional yesterday, we were made to understand that there is no more time, and that virtually all the occurrences of our present day reflect towards the reality of the truth of God's word that we are in the last days. And as a result, we must ensure to be ready for the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. We were enjoined to be like the five wise virgins. Our topic of today is similar to that of yesterday, Yesterday, we were reminded of the imminent second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Today, we are receiving a call to salvation. And we are told that there are basically two people who are involved in the call, the caller and the one who is being called. The caller in this case is God Almighty, reaching out to man and calling him to himself. From our Bible reading today, in Matthew chapter 11 verse 28, the scripture there reads, "Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." That labor could include the labor of sin, the labor of disobedience, the labor of arrogance and disregard for his word. Whatever that labor is, he's calling forth today that you just come and he will do the transformation himself. It is very important that we intentionally and deliberately accept the Lord Jesus Christ and walk in his ways, because scripture tells us that for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son. It is only those who believe in him that would not perish but would have everlasting life. John 3 verse 18 says, "He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he had not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God." He had rejected so great an opportunity, such an awesome privilege of salvation, and has chosen instead to suffer the rightful penalties, which of course he had the opportunity to receive pardon for, but he declined. Our Lord Jesus does not have a personal preference for whom he would save. It is whoever that comes to him that would be saved. One very important point that our Father and the Lord mentioned today is the fact that so many people miss out on this awesome privilege of salvation because they are considered wise in their own eyes. The God of this world has therefore chosen to blind their eyes from the truths of God's word that is able to save and rescue their souls. The wisdom of salvation to them sounds like foolishness. But we remember from scripture that God chooses the foolish things of this world to confound even the wise. Our lesson from this is that we must never let knowledge puff us up, because it ultimately leads to pride and destruction. Many times, destruction beyond repair. The Lord Jesus is still calling. He is saying that we come before him and exchange our yoke for his own. Then we would find rest. If you have not known the Lord Jesus Christ, make a decision for Jesus today. In the day that you hear his voice, do not harden your heart. Procrastination is a thief of time and eventually the thief of life. You can make that decision right now by saying with me, "Lord Jesus, I come before you today as a sinner. I believe you died for me and that you rose again. Please forgive me of my sins and cleanse me from all unrighteousness. I declare that I am saved and I am born again. In Jesus' name, amen." Praise God. If you have said this prayer and meant it, I want to assure you that you are now born again. Congratulations and welcome to the family of God. Please find a Bible-believing church and plant yourself that you may grow there. We'd still bow our heads and pray. We'd say, "Father, please uphold me up until the end in the name of Jesus. It is he that runs the race and endures till the end that gets the crown." Say, "Father, help me to run this race and to run it well. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen." Our Father, we have come to return thanks for this word today again. Thank you for daily loading us with your benefits. We ask today that we would continually be beneficiaries of the blessedness of salvation in Jesus' name. Help us to run this race until we see you face to face in glory. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. We have an action point today that says, "Thank God for the salvation of your soul." If, however, you are not yet saved, accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, then call upon him to save your soul. Praise God. In our Bible in 1 year reading plan for today, we read from the book of Proverbs chapter 4. Amen. Thank you for joining us today. We are glad to have you. We trust that you have been blessed. If you'd love to speak to someone or to receive updates like this daily, please send a WhatsApp or Telegram message to +234 80 986 11226. You can make a choice today to bless someone by sharing this with them. It is our prayer for us all today that when the roll is called in heaven, we will all be there in Jesus' name. Amen. Do have a blessed month ahead. Bye for now.
I believe you enjoyed today's devotional. We'd love to hear from you. Kindly leave a comment. You can connect with us on any of our social media handles attached. God bless you. Have a great day and see you tomorrow.